Hello everyone, today I will be explaining you about the antenna subsystems. So what are all the different types of antennas which are used in satellite communication? So those different types of antennas, we'll see it in this session. Now what is the learning outcome of this? So at the end of this session, the student will be able to explain and identify different types of antennas used in the satellites. Now, before going to the next slide, let us recall the different types of subsystems which are used in the satellites, as well as a basic knowledge of electromagnetic wave propagation, then types of polarization are needed. So electromagnetic wave propagation, in the sense the propagation of the wave, that is the electromagnetic characteristics of the wave that we have to know. Then what are the different types of polarization? So basically there may be horizontal polarization, or there may be a vertical polarization, or there may be an orthogonal polarization. So it depends upon the types of polarization. So now let us look at the basic antenna parameters. So if at all if you consider an antenna, so what are all the basic parameters that an antenna should have? Or in order to study the properties of an antenna, so what are all the basic parameters that one has to know about antenna? So those are radiation pattern, then second one, that is beam width, then antenna aperture, then antenna gain, directivity, as well as polarization. So now let us know what is radiation pattern. So radiation pattern is nothing but it is the plot of the electromagnetic field with respect to the frequency of observation, or you can say that different fields that will be emitted by the antenna, so they are plotted in a graph with respect to the frequency of operation. So that is nothing but the radiation pattern. So radiation pattern, it depends upon the physical structure of the antenna. So the physical structure of the antenna, it may be circular, or it may be rectangular one, or it may be some cross-sectional one. So it depends. So that is what we call it as the physical aperture of the antenna. So that is what aperture, in the sense the physical appearance. So basically the antenna aperture is classified into two types, that is effective aperture, then physical aperture. So physical aperture, in the sense the physical appearance of the antenna, whereas the effective aperture in the sense the area of the antenna which is responsible for the radiation pattern in a particular direction. So that is nothing but the effective aperture. Now let us look at the beam width. So what do you mean by the beam width? Basically the beam width is nothing but the radiation pattern, that is sometimes the radiation pattern, it may appear like a circle, or it may appear like a random structure. So it may take different forms. So that is nothing but the beam width. So antenna aperture, as I told you, antenna aperture is nothing but the physical appearance, that is physical aperture as well as the effective aperture. Now let us look at the antenna gain. So what do you mean by the antenna gain? So antenna gain is nothing but the property of the antenna which has the capability to produce radiation pattern in a effective way. So basically the gain of the antenna is measured in decibels. Now, directivity. So, what do you mean by the directivity of an antenna? Directivity of an antenna is nothing but it is the property of the antenna which will speak about the radiation pattern, how directional it is. In the sense, in what direction does the radiation pattern is large? Or you can say that the beam width with respect to a particular direction is nothing but the directivity. Again, directivity is measured in decibels. So I already told about the polarization. That is, polarization is nothing but it is the property of the electromagnetic wave where it is going to propagate in the medium. So if at all, if the electromagnetic field, or you can say the electric field, if it is perpendicular to the surface of the earth, then it is orthogonal polarization. So basically, polarization is being spoken with respect to the angle of electric field or the magnetic field with respect to the surface of the earth. So at what angle does the electric field propagates with respect to the surface of the earth? So that is nothing but the polarization. So polarization plays a very much important role while deciding the important factor of the antenna, that is directivity of the antenna. So if at all, if we have the polarization in a particular direction, so suppose if you have the antenna with respect to the surface of the earth, so if it is straight or if it is mounted somewhere, then the polarization will speak you about the electromagnetic propagation in a particular direction. So these are the important antenna parameters. Now let us move to the satellite antennas. So basically, which types of antennas are used in satellites? So what are the different types of antennas which are used in satellites? Now there are mainly four basic types are there. So those are wire antennas. Again, wire antennas can be divided into monopoles and dipoles, then horn antenna, then reflector antenna. So in the reflector antenna, we are going to have two types. That is the parabolic reflector antenna, then hyperbolic reflector antenna. So it depends. So it mainly depends upon the radiation pattern, or you can say the beam width. So the reflector antennas, they play a very much important role, especially in communication systems. Now the last one is array antennas. So what are these array antennas? Array antennas are nothing but the antennas which are arranged in a specific pattern. So specific pattern in the sense, suppose if we have a TV antenna like Aggie-Uda antenna, it is going to have the arrays of antennas. So that is nothing but the antenna array. So again, the beam width, or you can say that the radiation pattern, so it constitutes the different radiation patterns produced by all those antennas. So that is nothing but the array antenna. In array antenna, again we are going to have phased array antenna. So I will be speaking about what are these different phased array antenna as well as array antenna in the next slide. Now let us look at the antennas, how they are going to appear. So you can see in the slide, that is H-plane sectorial horn antenna, then pyramidal horn antenna, so E-plane sectoral horn. In the sense, so these E-plane or the H-plane, so they are nothing but the polarization of the electromagnetic wave. So suppose if it is a orthogonal polarization or if it is an horizontal polarization, then what type of antenna should be used? So that depends upon the polarization. So that is what horn antennas are available in different forms. So you can also see the canonical horn antenna. So usually these types of antennas, you can find it on the mobile towers. Now let us look at the reflector antennas. So these reflector antennas, you can see it in the slide. So it basically consists of the parabolic reflector antenna and then cast grain antenna. So the parabolic reflector antenna, it is going to be the primary radiator, which consists of the primary radiator, and then the cast grain antenna, you can see the sub reflector antenna. So these are all the umbrella like structures which have the capability of getting, or which have the capability of directing, you can say, so directing the radiation pattern in a particular pattern. Now let us look at the array antennas. So you can have a look at the array antennas in the slide. So array along y-axis, you can see that. Then array along x-axis, you can see there. Then array along the z-axis. It means that the antennas can be arranged in all the dimension. That is, in one dimension you can arrange, two dimension, as well as the three dimension. Now you can see the two dimensional array. So how does the arrays of antenna, so they are arranged in the y plane as well as in the x plane. Now you can have a look at the typical antenna subsystem on the satellite. So different types of antennas you can see there. That is, the receiving antenna, which is of 30 gigahertz, so which has been mounted on the satellite. You can also see the steerable antenna, means it has the property of steering in all directions. So then you can also have a look over the solar arrays, that is the power subsystem. Then you can also see about the range of frequency that these types of antennas are able to handle the frequency. That is 30 gigahertz, or you can say, suppose if the satellite link, if it's been designed, then always there will be the uplink frequency is always greater than the downlink frequency. So these are the references I have referred. So you can refer the textbook by Timothy Pratt, that is Satellite Communication Textbook by Timothy Pratt, that is second edition. Then I have also referred to the NPTEL courses. Then the best book that you can refer is Antennas and Wave Propagation textbook by John D. Cross. Thank you.